Do I use the remote?
You can. That would be good.
All right. So, hello everyone. My name is Nick Assise. I'm a senior Reagan fellow, and I'm here to tell you about my mentorship experience working at Burns & Lippin. So what is Burns & Lippin? Burns & Lippin is a personal injury firm in downtown Chicago. So if you get in a car accident or you have a workers' comp case or something like that, you would go to them and they would help you with your settlement. And it was really, I know it's only downtown Chicago, but for me it was kind of a big jump because I very rarely like visit downtown. Like I might go down like once a year for the aquarium or something. So it was a big leap, like commuting every Tuesday and Thursday by train to go down there and just learning all the train lines and stuff. But ultimately, it went really well. I learned a ton, and I was able to use the evenings to attend a pre-LSAT class downtown. So it all went really well. And this is a picture of my office. Sorry I didn't bother to clean off the desk for you guys. It's just, I didn't get a lot of pictures. It's just the nature of the internship. And something I loved a ton about this internship is the people there, they treated me like I was really part of the workforce. Like I wasn't some lackey like, oh, get the donuts, oh, get the whatever. Like, no, I was working there. They set me up with a really nice office. When the computer broke, they didn't just ask me to like bring in my laptop or something. They got a repair guy and got it all fixed. And I was really treated like a real member of the workforce there, which I really liked. And what exactly were my duties there? Well, there was the standard filing, this to there. And ironically, in the simple filing is where my lack of a law degree hindered me the most here. Because I was looking at a piece of paper, I'm like, is this a motion or an order? Or does this go in the pre-file or does this go in the witness deposition? And I just kind of got lost with the filing at times. But again, they were really helpful and able to guide me through. And then there was closing cases, which was also kind of similar to filing. It was really nice because I got to see the dozens and dozens of cases that I didn't get to experience. Because cases, by their very nature, take a very long time. The case I worked the most on, the actual incident happened in late 2014, and it only got settled near the end of my time there. So it's just the idea of these cases take so long that by closing them, I get to see a little insight into those cases I never really viewed. And then there was also just brainstorming. There was a lawyer there named Scott who, he was always super busy, but I worked with him the most, and he would always take some time out every day just to call me into his office, and we would discuss recent cases, like, this case isn't going so well, I think we might drop the charges, do you have any ideas, or hey, we got this new deposition from one of the witnesses, can you give it a summary? And the fact that he was so busy, sometimes he had to do this over the phone, he was just somewhere else, but he always took the time, and it was really meaningful, and I really appreciated it. Examining medical records was probably the low point of my time there. I have full respect for the doctors and the physical therapists and the physicians of the world, but they know how to write some boring documents. It's just not my forte reading through the endless records. But you know, it's part of the job. And during my last week on the job, I got to meet the guy who would be helping out in my place. And he was, again, doing the exact same thing. But he was fresh out of law school, and I'm just here at Eureka, which made it such a great opportunity. And now going into more of my primary duties, I would go through the depositions of the witnesses, because there's a lot of testimony that goes into these cases. And I have to go through 500 pages of stuff, like, oh, hold on, it's got to be in here somewhere. I could find where they said about the leg. Just, it would get so redundant. So I would go through the testimonies, find where they put each specific thing, and like, all right, here's where it talks about their occupation, here's where it talks about what happened, here's where it happens with the company. Just having all that info on hand is essential. And probably my favorite thing I did was help prepare with the cross-examinations. Unfortunately, not every witness tells the golden truth. That's why we have trials in the first place. So examining what happens and what they'll say and how to prepare for that is important. But talking about some examples of the cases, to the right here is a bit of an example of one of the cross-examinations I helped with. I had to shove out any names or anything, but it's just the idea of anticipating what questions they'll ask and offering something in response. But what were the cases? The case I worked with the most is a guy got his foot run over with a forklift. Pretty graphic stuff. I wouldn't show you the images even if I had them. That's not even the forklift. It's just a random forklift from Home Depot. I saw it one day and I'm like, hey, you know what? That might come in handy for my presentation. So I took a picture of it and boom, there it is. It did come handy for my presentation. But anyway. And so we were helping him with his case. And at one point, the defense hired a private eye to try to investigate him and say, like, hey, he's just faking all this stuff. But they weren't exactly the best private eye around, because if it was something like him running a marathon or playing tennis, then yeah, they might have a case, but he was just mowing his lawn very slowly. And it was just kind of, we watched the video, we talked about it, we were prepared, like, is this really what we're looking for here? A video of a man mowing his lawn as definitive proof he's lying? I don't think so. And just overall, the case went really well, and the Our client ended up getting a settlement of a little under $750,000, which was really nice. There were other cases, of course. There was not all of them were that exciting. Like one of them was someone in a car crash that was about like less than 8 miles an hour, but they can't all be exciting. And so just talking about my favorite moments, when you get into the field of law, sometimes the trivial things come up and end up being relevant or not relevant on both sides. And on our side, going back to the forklift case for a second, at one point he suffered from kidney stones during the procedure, and we wanted to try to argue that the kidney stones were related to the incident, because again, more money for our client. But what it really ended up just being is a very annoyed doctor on the witness stand saying, "This has nothing to do with this. I went to school for this." Just the kind of going back and forth. But on the opposite side, with the prosecution, they would say some of the silly stuff too. Like we had to hire an OSHA expert to talk about the forklift safety procedure and why this was invalid. And he was just super blunt with his deposition. It was hilarious to read. He's like, "This is the easiest case I've had in years. Proper forklift procedure is not running over people's feet. This one's not hard." But just, I wanted to give some special thanks to the people who helped me out. Everyone at the law office was essential. Mr. Burns, the owner, and then there was Scott, who I mentioned earlier, some of the other people, Tammy, Celia, Josh, they were all just essential to my experience. And then Dr. T and Sherry Rich, of course, I could have never had this opportunity if it weren't for them and the Reagan program, and I'm really grateful. And my parents were also super helpful, especially like when I got lost downtown that one time. They were just always able to help me out. And I know this isn't super relevant to the thing, to my internship, but I lost my train ticket at one point, and the train conductor was nice enough to give me a new one after we couldn't find it, and he just deserves a shout out for that. So anyway, that's my presentation. Thank you very much. Oh, I almost forgot my contact information. I have my contact information right here, and if you ever need a good law office, if you get hit by a car or something, I have their contact information up there as well. Thank you, everyone.